For the last 4 weeks, I've been playing around with the new 3ds Max 2023. Let me show you what I found out. This video is sponsored by Autodesk. They gave me an early access to the new 3ds Max 2023, so I can test the new tools and features and present them to you as soon as possible. I'm sure you are very excited, so let's get started. First, let's take a look at the major update to the Retopology modifier. I have a photo-scanned rock in my scene. The mesh is crazy dense. I will add a Retopology modifier and show you new features. Now, we process complex mesh data way faster using a new pre-process option found here. When active, Reform will generate a simplified mesh that accurately follows the input geometry. The remeshed data will then be used to generate clean quad geometry. This simplified process removes the need to prepare meshes with modifiers like subdivide or pro-optimize. This is pretty cool, isn't it? Face count, on the other hand, controls the density of the mesh. Let's make it more dense. You can control the progress here. At any time, you can turn it off and on without the need to compute it again. This new update also makes it possible to propagate existing mesh data, such as smoothing groups, UVs, normals, and vertex color, to the new Retopology mesh output. Here, I have another photo-scanned model with the texture already unwrapped. Let's add the Retopology modifier. By checking the Auto Edge option, I have the flexibility to transfer import mesh data, such as UV channel, for example. Let's click Compute. This way, the texture stays perfectly unwrapped in a new Retopology mesh. In addition, you still have access to the original unwrap modifier's results. It's gonna be really useful when working with photo-scanned geometries, which are getting more and more popular. Now we have the new selection method inside the editable poly. Let me show you. Here is the model of rocks from my Megascans library. I will enable polygon selection. Here it is, the occluded selection mode. When enabled, you will only select polygons which are visible in the viewport. You may think that we got this option before with ignore back facing, but this option only excludes polygons which are facing the view with the back side. You can do a lot of cool things with that. For example, you can select all the polygons from the top view and detach the selection. Then, you can use the new object to create snow as I've done here. That's just one way to use it. Let me know in the comments how you would use it. We have all been there. You're working on a huge project. You're super focused, and suddenly, out of nowhere, what are your options now? Depending on what type of person you are, you either wait calmly for about 60 seconds, or...
Oh my god!
Turning off the backup is not an option. Many times I lost hours of work because of that. Thankfully now, we have a handy solution for this issue. Let me show you. Here, we have the Auto Backup toolbar. By default, this icon will be active when you open 3ds Max. When it's active, Max is looking for any changes to your scene state. When something changes, it figures out that Auto Backup should be done. As soon as I start working on something, the timer will start the countdown. When the timer gets to zero, the auto backup will be done. It's awesome that we have a visual of when the auto backup will be performed at all times. If you want to skip the auto backup, you can reset it at any time using this icon. On top of that, there are some improvements in auto backup preferences. You can quickly access preferences by right-clicking on this icon. In the previous versions of Max, we got only these three options. Now we can also pretend the auto backup with the scene name. So instead of having auto backup 01, auto backup 02, and so on, you will get scene name, -lan, auto backup 01, and so on. It's a great update. Many times before, I got multiple scenes open at the same time and I couldn't find the correct auto backup. I'm sure it happened to you as well. You can also compress on auto backup. This way, the file will save faster and decide if you want to display the timer or not. This small update is probably my favorite feature. I'm sure it saved me a keyboard. Or two. New and updated keyboard shortcuts have been assigned for various operations found in Unwrap. For example, we can quickly do loop selection with Alt plus L shortcut, or create a palette seam with Shift plus P shortcut. Shortcuts work in the UV editor as well, like Shift plus A for pack. You can check all the shortcuts in the hotkey editor under the Unwrap UVW category. You can also change the shortcuts or assign new shortcuts to the options that don't have one. You guys should already know that I am a huge fan of shortcuts, so this update is very appreciated. Another huge modeling update after last year's Smart Extrude feature. Place working pivots provides a method to rapidly adjust the position and orientation of the pivots. You can access working pivots in three different ways, using this toolbar, from the tool menu, or from quads. This option lets you place the working pivot on any vertex, edge, face component, or midpoints of those components on the active object in their scene. When you click and hold, you can also choose the orientation of the pivot. You can combine it with a smart extrude, which will provide a really fast modeling workflow. Another really cool feature is the ability to create a grid for the working pivot. We can use it, for example, to draw a shape on it. With the usual grid snap tool, I can align it perfectly to the center of the grid, which is the location of the working pivot. I will extrude it and attach it to the model. Now I can use Smart Extrude to create a boolean. Love these options. Modeling will be so easy now. Next week, I will publish the video where I will get more in depth into working pivots. The Sheen Layer has been added to the Arnold material. It helps to render soft microfiber fabrics like velvet, satin, and silk. In the past, we had to use the follow-off map to do this, but now it's much more simplified. I took the scene from my interior visualization online course to test it. I have prepared a simple Arnold material with diffuse and normal textures. You can find the Sheen effect here. Let me start the interactive rendering. Amount controls how strong the effect is. Let's start with the value 1. Obviously, it's too strong, so I will decrease it. 0.4 looks good. And let's test different roughness values. Low roughness keeps the specular highlights at the grazing angle, and as it increases, the sheen reflection dominates. I will set it to 0.45. We can also change the color of the effect. make it darker and a bit reddish. And that's it! Looks pretty good, right? Autodesk introduced glTF support in the new 3ds Max. glTF is a file format used to showcase 3D models on the web and online stores. We can now easily publish 3D assets directly to glTF for use in web applications, online stores, and so on, while ensuring visual quality is maintained. You can find the glTF material here. You can apply it to your model as any other material. Now, we have the access to the glTF material preview, which provides us with the ability to accurately work on the assets in the viewport. It's eliminating guesswork and giving us the confidence that assets will look the same in different environments, outside of 3ds Max. When the model is ready for a glTF viewer, you can then use the new real-time exporter to export mesh data and its associated material. Then, you just have to drag and drop the model to this website. I will put the link to it in the description, so you can play around with it. Here, I can see lots of potential in the future. You don't have to sit and wait for a client to come to you with a request. Instead, you can, for example, develop workflow to showcase 3D previews of products online. I'm sure many online store owners would love to have this kind of presentation on their website. Let me know in the comments what do you think about new 3ds Max and which option is your favorite. If you want to learn how to create amazing architectural visualizations and animations in 3ds Max, I'd like to invite you to join our online courses. Click here to check them out on our website. Bye bye!